On one of the car assembly lines in Japan, there is a system capable of making decisions faster than a human can blink. Cameras detect the slightest deviations on the car body, and within a thousandth of a second, the robot adjusts its actions, even if the operator gave a command a moment earlier. This is not just automation. It's a combination of high-precision sensors and a neural network that predicts a possible error before it even occurs. Such machines don't just act faster, they learn from their own mistakes. In aviation manufacturing, neural systems are already assessing the strength of components in real time, rejecting potentially dangerous parts with an accuracy unattainable even for experienced engineers. And this isn't hypothetical, it's mass production. Such algorithms don't just learn from millions of scenarios, they teach themselves, evolving without human involvement. But the most shocking thing is military technology. Drones controlled by artificial intelligence not only fly without human intervention, but also coordinate with each other in flight, choosing the optimal strategy for attack or defense. Their decisions no longer depend on direct commands. They act within the set objective, improvising better than any operator. When a human doesn't have time to react, the machine has already completed the task. This is not just a revolution, it's a change of roles. We no longer control, we observe. And here's what's truly frightening. Some of these machines don't even need engines. You wouldn't hear it even at arm's length, even though in front of you is a machine capable of pumping thousands of gallons of water or generating pressure comparable to that of the ocean at a depth of 6 miles. We're talking about magnetic turbines and pumps with no moving parts. There are no spinning blades, no grinding shafts. Instead, an electromagnetic field is used to propel liquid or gas at incredible speed and in complete silence. Such machines are already being used in nuclear power, pharmaceuticals, and even rocket technology. No friction, no overheating, no wear and tear. This means decades of reliability, silent power with no vibration, and something that can't be detected by a microphone. One example of this is liquid metal pumps used to cool reactors. They operate on eddy currents, creating movement in the medium that gives you goosebumps. Everything rotates, but nothing moves. And yes, this effect is already being used in the development of future weapons. With this level of power and silence, even the most advanced spies are left guessing. Is the machine running, or is it just background noise? But what if we told you that some parts of these systems aren't even solid? Imagine a metal that's not just liquid, but responds to commands as if it has a mind of its own. This isn't science fiction, it's gallium and its alloys. They flow, yet remain metallic, can conduct electricity, take on any shape, and change their state under the influence of a field. Researchers in California have already made controllable robots from this material that slide through pipes, seep through openings, and even return to their original shape after being deformed. These machines don't spin, don't drive, don't run. They literally flow in the desired direction. In industry, such materials have begun to be used for movable joints, cooling, and also in medicine, for delivering drugs to specific points in the body. These are no longer just parts, but living mechanics, where shape is a temporary concept. The most frightening thing is that they can merge into new forms, imitating organic structures. A machine that chooses its own shape sounds like the beginning of a new stage in the evolution of technology. And now imagine if such a liquid decided to act exactly like a surgeon. You hold your breath, there's a patient on the table, and a life is at stake. But at the operating table, it's not a human, it's a robot. It doesn't breathe, doesn't blink, doesn't tremble. Every one of its movements is precise to tenths of a micron. Such machines are already operating in the US and Japan. They remove tumors, suture blood vessels, and make incisions as thin as a hair. We're talking about robots like the Da Vinci systems, machines that not only replicate the doctor's movements, but also adjust them in real time. If the surgeon's hand trembles, the robot smooths it out. If the tissue turned out to be thinner than expected, the machine adapted on the fly. Some of them are capable of performing up to 300 operations a year without any loss of precision. No breaks, no fatigue, no maybe tomorrow. And all this with minimal human intervention. The newer models learn from every movement and suggest options to the surgeon. Yes, the machine is already advising the doctor on how to work, referring to tens of thousands of previous cases. But what if we apply this level of precision to speed, to transportation, where every millisecond counts? On the surface, everything looks simple. A train, tracks, a cab. But beneath this exterior lies an engineering marvel that challenges the laws of physics. Maglev trains, floating above the tracks without friction, are already reaching speeds of over 600 miles per hour, and they do it without a single wheel. Magnetic levitation eliminates friction, which means acceleration becomes almost instantaneous. China, Japan, and Germany are already building lines where travel time is cut in half. The most impressive thing is the stability. Even at breakneck speeds, the train doesn't sway, and inside it's so quiet, it's as if you're gliding through the air. Vacuum tunnels and hyperloop technologies add to this by completely eliminating air resistance. Tests show that the capsule can accelerate to airplane speeds while consuming dozens of times less energy. But there's one aspect that makes these machines especially dangerous if they ever decide to think for themselves. 1,000 parts a day. Not a single mistake. This isn't just an ordinary machine tool in front of us, but an adaptive machine with a neural network core. Its task is not just to process metal, but to understand exactly how to do it at every given moment. The temperature has changed, the material is a bit denser, the tool is worn out, the system has already adjusted the force and speed. This machine doesn't wait for commands. It senses the details on its own. Cameras, lasers, pressure, and vibration sensors turn it into a being capable of learning. Today it just drills, but in a week it will optimize the entire process better than a whole team of engineers. One factory in South Korea has switched entirely to such production lines. Productivity increased by 1.5 times, and the number of defects dropped to almost zero. The main thing is that these machines remember every stage. They store the history of all changes and suggest themselves how to become even more precise and faster. And if before operators used to control the machines, now it's increasingly the machines that teach the operators, often through a screen where they explain what they're doing and why. But what if, instead of a screen, the machine itself starts talking to you? You hear a voice, it sounds calm, without pauses, but it's too precise. It's not a recording and not a person. It's a machine. Today, voice interfaces control elevators, cars, production lines, and even entire buildings. And they sound so natural that you can only tell them apart from a real person by their timbre, if you're lucky. But it's not just about the voice. These AI systems understand intonation, stress, and emotions. If an engineer speaks in a panic, the system will increase safety measures. If the voice is calm, it operates in normal mode. Some machines are already capable of full-fledged dialogue, including humor, clarifications, and even provocations if necessary to keep the operator's attention. A logistics center in Germany has implemented an AI assistant that trains new employees. It talks, demonstrates, and adapts to each individual. After 2 weeks, workers forget they're not talking to a person and begin to trust it. The most amazing thing is that the voice can control an entire process, from startup to shutdown. This means you can start production without pressing a single button. And all this while the machine remains stationary. But what if it starts to move and act in critical situations? Fire. The smoke is so thick you can't see your hand in front of your face. People can no longer go inside. But at that moment, he enters the building, a robot. It isn't afraid of fire, doesn't lose its bearings, and doesn't panic. The rescue machine is equipped with a thermal imager, gas sensors, manipulators, and armor capable of withstanding extreme temperatures. Such devices are already being used in Japan, the USA, and China. Their task is to find survivors, evacuate them, or neutralize the threat. Some of them can not only move objects, but also provide first aid to victims, literally administering medication, supplying oxygen, and pulling bodies out from under debris. During the earthquake in Mexico, one such machine went where people could not. It found a child whom no one else could hear. Infrasound and a neural network made it possible to detect the barely perceptible breathing under a multi-ton slab. And this is just the beginning. New models are capable of operating in radioactive environments, on water, and even underwater. But all of this is in a world where there is energy. But what if a machine could learn to predict danger before it appears? You don't even know that the system has already saved your life. At the factory, where multi-ton presses are spinning, AI monitors the rotation speed, pressure, and even the operator's behavior. One wrong move, and the press should have crushed your hand. But the machine stopped before you could even blink. Predictive algorithms are a new era. They analyze millions of data points in real time and determine what, where, and when something might go wrong. In airplanes, they predict equipment failure dozens of hours before the sensors even indicate a problem. In cars, they can slow down if the driver yawns and loses concentration. One of the largest chemical companies in Europe uses a system that predicts a leak 40 minutes in advance. There isn't even a smell yet, but the system has already started the ventilation. This isn't a reaction, it's foresight. And if before an accident was a matter of chance, now it's a matter of algorithm. But machines are not only capable of preventing things. Some of them don't even look like machines at all. You might not even notice them. It's the size of a fingernail, but it can control processes at a factory, regulate the pressure in an airplane engine, or cut off power to an entire building. We're talking about micro-machines, miniature devices built into equipment that you wouldn't even suspect are there. Such systems are placed inside structures, pipes, engines, and reactors. They collect data, make decisions, and send commands. Some can change shape and move around to inspect hard-to-reach areas. These are no longer passive sensors, they are active control elements. The military uses them for espionage, engineers for wear monitoring, and scientists for autonomous laboratories. In medicine, micro-robots are introduced into the body and can perform analysis, then disintegrate. They are invisible, yet they control everything. They don't break down, they're simply replaced with new ones. And that makes them the most resilient class of technology on the planet. But there is one technology technology you won't find in catalogs. It changes not only the shape of the machine, but also how we perceive it. You look at a building, and a second later, it seems to disappear or change shape. No, it's not graphics or magic, it's the work of machines creating an illusion. Dynamic facades made of moving panels, controlled by AI, respond to light, shadow, movement, and even the gaze of a passerby. They trick the brain, making you perceive the object differently from what it actually is. In Japan, machines have been installed that can change the appearance of a building's facade every 5 seconds. They don't just move beautifully, they control the perception of space. They're used in advertising, architecture, and even for camouflaging military equipment. In European museums, moving structures are used that begin to transform into a new image as you approach. All of this happens without human intervention. The machine analyzes the viewer's position, the lighting, and adapts the image accordingly. But what's most frightening is that such machines are learning to influence perception, not just visually. Technologies are being developed that can alter sounds, vibrations, and even smells. When you can't trust your own senses, who controls reality? Maybe it's no longer you. But while some machines are camouflaging themselves, others are preparing for the next evolutionary step. A breakdown used to mean a stop, but now, not anymore. Some machines are capable of repairing damage on their own. By using shape memory materials, liquid metals, and nanopolymers, machines can literally heal cracks, restore conductivity, or even replace parts of their own structure. In South Korea, they have already tested a robot that, when its body is damaged, injects a polymer into itself that hardens under light. 15 minutes later, it's back in action, without any human intervention. In aviation, composites are used that contain built-in microcapsules with hardening agents. If damage occurs, the capsules burst and the crack is filled with a healing compound. More advanced robot models incorporate self-diagnostic algorithms. They don't just detect a malfunction, they know where to find the resources to fix it. Sometimes this comes at the cost of temporarily sacrificing another component. The machine makes a choice. This isn't just self-repair, it's the beginning of autonomous mechanical evolution. But what if, in the future, the machine starts changing itself not only when something breaks? Today they're still in laboratories, but tomorrow they'll replace everything. We're talking about hybrid systems. Yes, the ones that combine mechanics, biology, quantum computing, and artificial intelligence. These aren't just new machines, they're a new kind of technology, synthetic organisms. Research in the US has already produced the first samples, semi-living tissues that move under the influence of electrical signals and can be integrated into mechanisms. As a result, we get living engines that can contract, stretch, and regenerate. Quantum machines analyze not millions, but trillions of combinations, selecting the optimal solution in fractions of a second. Such technologies could potentially control entire cities, from traffic to power grids. And in biomechanics, there are now designs capable of adapting to their owner, exoskeletons that sense muscles and amplify movement precisely where needed. These are not just machines. This is a future that doesn't buzz, grind, or require oil. It breathes, grows, and learns. And while we were getting used to one level of progress, machines have moved ahead forever.